All right, all right. We are back. The dynamic duel is back. I know we had a little break, a little Easter, a little day thing going down, but you know, we're back. Man, we're back to give you that
we're
shit you need.
Back.
Yeah. This is Them Guys Podcast, the podcast that only gives you a true perspective of sports, not a lie, not the fake, the phony, and let's get into it, man. What about that women's tournament, man? That Final Four was amazing, right?
Man, you know it was great, man. I ain't gonna tell you no lie. I put a little money on South Carolina. You know what I'm saying? Won a little dough, yeah. But did a couple parlays. I picked on my girl Raven. Thought she was gonna be a great player to pick, but it was the Samoan girl who really.
Yeah, was she from Brazil or whatever, something like that?
No, Raven from some ghetto somewhere. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
Hey, you talking about the center?
Yeah, that little redhead horse. What's her name?
Dang,
the pack hair. What's her name?
I don't know her name, man. I know she gonna be the fourth pick in the WNBA draft,
yeah.
Or second pick maybe.
Well, you know they still said they got to check the equipment after the game. But for right now, the Gamecocks have won. Keyword on Cox won the women's Final Four. But, yeah, they played a great game, man. They kind of locked Caitlin down. So I know she kind of –
They ain't lock her down. Don't say that. Don't start that narrative, boss.
Man, they kind of locked her down.
They ain't lock her down because she just didn't play up to her talent. She had open shots. She just didn't make them.
Well – I think they had a good defense. I think she got tired of that shit, you know, the whole tournament, everybody doing the isolations and the double teams. You know, that kind of drains you in the tournament, you know what I'm saying? It's not like you got, like, a seven-game series like that.
Man,
NBA,
she plays the whole game, man.
Yeah, then she's the offense. She's the fucking offense. What was killing me, though, like, every time it was commercial, they was, like, trying to give it to Iowa. Like, every time it was commercial, you see a –
Okay,
a,
let me ask. Okay, what about the game? Commercial. What about the game before with the offensive foul, though?
Oh, that was some bullshit. Now, that was they was trying to bring them to the Final Four championship game. That was a crazy – I have never seen that in any, like, form of any basketball game.
They messed up the whole game.
They messed up
that.
The whole game. They killed the whole momentum of the game. Like, that offensive charge, I mean, the – when she threw the pick, like it was the softest pick.
It was a move. It was a moving pick, but you don't make that call.
You gotta let the players play that.
Yeah, you just don't make that call. And the problem is though, they should have let them go in overtime. But they so worried about getting Caitlin to the finals.
Yeah, they
weren't
about the
ratings.
Yeah, they weren't about the ratings.
You know what I'm saying? So they was like, "Hey, fuck that, man. We gotta get Caitlin. Caitlin for the W, goddamn it."
Yeah, that's basically what they were trying to do. They was making sure Caitlin Clark was getting there. Yeah, but, like, every commercial I seen, like, man, like, after the, like, they go to commercial, it'd be like a Gatorade Caitlin Clark, or she got a movie
Jeez,
coming out.
She is the number one women's player in professional in college right now. You have to. You have to promote her as such.
Come on, man.
Nah, you got to promote
Kobe,
her as such.
Come on.
She's the female Kobe. She's, listen, before you even knock my knowledge, my argument.
Okay.
Now listen, Ice Cube was willing to pay her $5 million to come to the Big Three, right? $5 million. She's the reason that the WNBA is going to start paying these players more and treating them better. She's the fucking combined Magic and Larry Bird of women's basketball now.
Okay, okay. I'm with that. But it's crazy to see like the hype about it, like. To think that she can play any parts of the man game is crazy.
It's not thinking she can play. It's for promotion, man. It's ratings. She is a ratings draw right now. Okay. So you have to give it to her.
Okay, I can see that. But I don't know. But like,
We all know I'm a marketing genius, and then you have to market her, man. You know what I'm saying?
Definitely you are a marketing genius.
Thank you. Appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you.
So I can see you have to, man. I have Caitlin on fucking selling tampons, everything. She'd be out being a marketing whore right now.
I told you, man. That's where it's at, man. Tampons is where it's at, bro. But yeah, man. Caitlin, she does deserve what she, you know, even the coach from South Carolina said that, you know, she is the GOAT, So
she's not the fucking GOAT, G. Breonna Stewart is the GOAT.
Now, Juju is going to be, in a couple of years, Juju going to be the face of women basketball.
Breonna Stewart is the GOAT, G. She won 4 national championships in 4 years and was 3-time MVP of those national championships.
Yeah, we niggas she was playing that year.
Get the fuck out of here.
Juju is going to be the future of, she's the female Carmelo Anthony, bro. You're hearing it here first. I'm not even saying nothing that's not like good news. Like, everybody know that at this point with UFC.
I like
she's the reason why Bronny leaving UFC.
Oh, you talking about the love and basketball?
Love and basketball. He lost the game, so he had to leave. Hey,
Bronny gave her that ball and said, "I want to play you for your heart." Juju bust his ass.
Yo, by the way, I like bitches.
Killed that man, boy.
Yeah,
that boy Bronny don't know what he about to do.
Yeah, so the recent news about Bronny is that he's supposed to be entering the draft, but he still got his college eligibility, which I guess he's not going to sign with an agency. He's just going
to
try.
No, the thing is, though, they have him going to the draft. He's going to participate in the draft stuff, but they're going to see where he's going to get drafted at.
Right.
And if he's not going to get drafted high, they're going to send his ass back to where LeBron high school buddy coach at. You know what I'm saying?
What college is he at? I think it was some
bootleg ass shit.
That's crazy, man. That's all. Look, at this point, give him an internship with Rich Paul at your secret agent company and let him do that, because like I don't know if he's like an NBA player, bro.
But I'm gonna tell you the level of my pettiness though, fam. If I was Pat Riley, I would draft Bronny and send him to Miami Heat, and boy, I work the shit out of Bronny, make him an all star like LeBron. I mean, like Jimmy Butler, man.
Yeah, definitely, definitely. I mean. I think with Bronny, he definitely has an opportunity, a great opportunity, once in a lifetime opportunity that nobody else is gonna get. But at the same time, I believe that like right now he's getting forced in a situation that he's not ready for as a player and as a young man. Like, I think it's a lot of pressure.
Wait a minute. You think he don't want to go to the league?
Even if he didn't want to go to the league, I think you really wouldn't have no choice being LeBron James' son.
No,
LeBron
saying,
wants it. So
no, no,
bad.
No. I'm saying you think he wants to go to college still and not go pro this soon, or what are you saying?
I'm thinking that maybe this is not his dream. Maybe it's just LeBron's
dream. It is LeBron's dream.
You know what I'm saying? It's not really some shit he want to do. I don't think he probably know what the hell he want to do. To be honest.
Did you know what you wanted to do at 17, 18?
That's what I'm saying. So, like, being pressured by, like, the league and the world to be an NBA player is a crazy situation, man. To be in this fucking once in a few type of situation, you know?
But, see, they compare his game to, like, somebody who's not able to be a star yet, you know? He has to be a compatible player. You know, he's like a 3-and-D guy. You know, he's more, what's the, Bruce Bowen than LeBron James. You know what I'm saying? So,
yeah, that's bad when your father's Bruce. Like, that's like saying, my father's Michael Jordan, but, you know, I'm more of a P.J. Armstrong type of fucking. Like, nobody wants that type of fucking title when your father's the best, one of the best players. You want to. So try to surpass that, and that's fucking impossible.
That's
like,
true.
Especially, you know what I'm saying, your father's 6'9", you 6'2".
But but the thing is, if he stays in college, he has to go somewhere where he's the man. He got to average like 25, 10, and 8 somewhere.
He
got
to go, so maybe going to that little bullshit school that is that LeBron's, not calling it bullshit, whatever school you're at, sorry, but your bullshit school.
I know, it starts with a D, no Diddy.
No Diddy.
I know it starts with a D. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, so whatever school that LeBron James' friend from high school is at, he's going to have to, like, dominate where he's at, because the competition he's going to have is not going to be like the competition he was having at UFC or if he would have went to Ohio State, you know?
I can't see him going to Ohio State either.
Yeah, I thought that was the move, but I guess not.
He's going to be the same at USC. He's not going to get a lot of tick. He might start at Ohio State, but he's not going to get a lot of tick. He's going to be role player again. You know what I'm saying?
You on the bench again on Ohio State?
So you can't really trust Bronny, man. His game, like, they keep saying his game's not made for college. Then let his ass go to the G League then. You know what I'm saying? If you want to go to the G League and start your career and become better at it, then that's possible. You know what I'm saying? You just have to play and stay up with the tempo of the game. You know what I'm saying? So I don't think Bronny's the superstar that he's being made out to be yet. But it can lead to that. You know what I'm saying? If he puts in the time, get drafted by the Heat, you know, go down there and practice real hard. Because I think he's going to be a great practice player that can.
So he's going to be a practice player. He's going to be a two-way league player.
No, he's going to be able to develop, though. I think he needs to develop more. You know what I'm saying? His game is not fit yet. He's still growing, man. I think I grew, like, you know what I'm saying?
A little bit taller,
right, you know what I'm saying? After I turned 18.
I think I grew like an inch or two, you know, depending on you who you ask. But you know what I'm saying? No Diddy. But no, that was both of you, no Diddy. But anyway, yeah, I think, I don't know, man. I think a person like Bronny James would benefit from staying like all 4 years in the college. But he ain't got that option with LeBron James, you know what I'm saying? LeBron James.
LeBron can still play 4 more years.
I don't know.
But will he be at the averaging 25, 7, 8 still at that in 4 years? No. But he doesn't want to see a drop off in his game, I'm assuming. So Bronny just need to just take his time, man, stay in college, especially another year, develop his game, become a little bit better. Like they say, Angel Reese, if she stayed in college and just said F school, right, and just worked on her offensive game, she probably could have been the number one pick next year in a WNBA draft.
Nah, she's too thirsty to get that money. She's doing Vogue.
She getting paid now, though.
She probably,
bro,
got OnlyFans coming.
Angel Reese is getting paid now, though. You know what I'm saying?
She's getting a lot of money.
She probably will make more in a WNBA because then she can start being sexualized by it's marketing. She's going to be sexualized when.
You already did it for Sports Illustrated. Right. She did that cover, you know what I'm saying? And then she up here crying about being sexualized. Like, you don't want to put the bikini on, Shirley. Like, no, mad at me.
But see, they trying to change the narrative about women having to sell their body. Not sell their body, but sell sex to make a living. And you'll see Caitlin Clark, she's just,
no offense, but I'll be the nigga to say it. I'll be the nigga to say it. Hey. I couldn't get a wood in the fucking look, man. She's not it. Let's just say that she's not it. Not even after two shots at the bar. You
damn.
Of Everclear. I don't think I'm going,
damn,
bro. That got to be a late night. Like, we talking like 3:30 shit. Like that. Yeah, she got that big bird nose. It's like, I'm like, I need to start roasting her. But yeah, she the goat. She the goat literally. She look like a goat literally. But anyway. Yeah, I mean, I think I'm just happy that finally the women's game is getting some type of notoriety, because it was getting to a point where it was like, are we going to have to close the WNBA, and you know what I'm saying, and stop opportunities for these young ladies, you know?
Now, I'm not going to lie. I love them tickets that we get, them $35 front
row. Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I don't think they're going
to. And they raise them tickets, I'm going to be pissed at the motherfucker.
Damn. That's going to piss the motherfucker off right there,
yeah,
boy.
Yeah.
$35. Oh, Jesus.
I can't go. I can't go. But, yeah, man. Well, I wish all the ladies the best. You know, Clark, Reese. I don't think Paige is leaving. Now, and Juju's not leaving yet. But
Paige should leave, though.
Yeah, it's wasting the time, man, Connecticut.
But I think Paige won a ring, and she was injured them 2 years. So she wants to get a ring.
Ain't like she going to be like her draft spot will drop, you know, just because of that. Like, everybody knows she's one of the top. Before they was talking about Clark, they was talking about her. So it's like, to me, I guess since they ain't making millions of dollars, it's like ain't no rush.
But they making money because of NIL deals.
Yeah, it's no rush because of NIL now. I think that's part of the thing that's going to save the college game, because people are going to stay a little longer and get some bread.
Shit, motherfuckers ain't watching the men. The men's is terrible. That boy 7'4", man, soft as charming.
Oh, my God. You talking about old boy from Purdue? Yeah.
Soft as charming, boy.
Yeah, so get into that. Who you got tomorrow? You got
I don't know, nigga. I'm
Connecticut or Connecticut or Purdue, man. It's a fruit bowl, man.
All right. I'm betting on Purdue to cover, cause UConn been hitting the spread all year, but I think this game they're not gonna hit it. So UConn's gonna win, but I'm going for the spread on Purdue.
Nah, I think you need to go with Connecticut on that, man. I think the game's gonna get close, like in the first half, second half. Connecticut just gonna get loose. That's like this game where we all predicted, like, you know, it was finna be, you know, it's close in the beginning because the refs gonna call some bullshit, but then, you know, the natural shit that's gonna happen is gonna happen.
Bro, I ain't gonna lie, I wanted North Carolina State to get in there, cause that big boy remind me of Zach Randolph, boy.
Oh, Z-Bo.
Yeah.
That nigga was cracking jokes this the whole time. I don't know how serious he is about basketball, but I mean, we'll see when he gets to the next level. You got to drop a few pounds.
He's trying to get him to play tackle in the NFL, though.
Oh, for real? So he a two-way player? Like two league player?
Nah, I doubt that, but.
Yeah, I mean, whatever opportunities, man. What's good about March, though, is just like all the opportunities these kids getting now. They getting NILs. I'm seeing through the Facebook and Instagram feed that they like doing little sponsors and shit, little T-shirt deals and stuff.
That boy DJ from North Carolina, that boy got 6 deals because they made it to the Final Four. Congrats,
man.
My bro.
Yeah, congrats.
Get that money.
Get that bread, man. That's what it's all about. It's about making money at the end of the day, man. That's what you go to college for, to, you know, eventually get some bread. You don't go there for the, you know, just for experience and hitting white women.
Dang, you saw the way them cheerleaders jumped that
old
boy.
Oh, it was too quick. Like, oh, I never seen you except at school.
Yeah, you know, probably had him in a bed like Ray Allen and he got gay.
Oh, man. Yo, I wanted to go to Tech U. I was looking for that. Yeah, I know this spot. I was mad when that wasn't a real school.
Get out of here.
Like, yo, Tech U, that's what I had
to have. Sign me up, boy. I'm ready for my visit, coach.
Oh, man. But yeah, man, I hope it's a good game. This at least it'll be a competitive game. Then I'll be happy with that result. But both of them teams, I'm not really happy about.
Man, that game, I'm gonna be watching that game probably on the phone. You know what I'm saying? To the second half. If it's a good game, then you get more into it. You know what I'm saying?
Right, right, right. I kind of hope it goes like some overtime. That's for me to watch. I don't fall asleep.
Exactly.
Through it. I'm telling the truth. This is the sad truth about it, man.
Like, they coach, like, he ain't even good. That's Bobby Hurley's brother. You know
what
I'm
saying? Bobby Hurley's brother couldn't make no team.
He ain't even
shit.
Got no name. Like, that's Bobby Hurley's brother. No, you're not Dan Hurley or your Bobby Hurley brother. Yeah,
you're Bobby. You're Bobby, man. Okay, chill out.
Straight up.
Yeah, man. Yeah. But speaking of, well, I guess we're going to turn to a different page, a different type of game, a different type of sport. What do you think about this whole J. Cole Kendrick situation going on right now?
You know, I'm going K. Dot all day.
K. Dot?
I'm from the West Side, man.
West Side.
You know what I'm saying?
West Side, Mike.
I ain't from the West Side of Chicago, though.
Yeah, yeah, that's a whole different city. Yeah, just let you know.
Put that on me, boss. You know what I'm saying?
So I was like, man, this nigga Vice Lord, man. What's going on?
Gonna be like KD out here. I mean, KG.
KD.
Lord.
What up, Lord?
Lord.
Yo, The equivalent. No,
I'm best with that, you. Lord. Do that.
Throw your V's up. But anyway, I think it's crazy that like at this it takes to this point where they start actually dissing each other. Like they gonna wait to the like they late 30s to start getting at each other now, man. I'm like, I think they've been having beefs. They've been having like little subliminals with each other, but. I'm just happy we're going to get some bars out of this because, like, these be getting, like, boring now.
Sometimes it's like it's too late. It's like Floyd and fucking Pacquiao.
Oh, yeah. That's what it feel like. That's the exact feeling. You dead on with that. You did. It's
y'all
like.
Y'all going to wait till y'all up in this age, man. We want that when y'all was in y'all 20s, man. Yeah. Y'all prime.
Motherfucker going to wait till the accounts get a little loaded. Like, all right, what's battle now? You know what I'm saying? Drake was saying quiet in this shit, though.
No, I just saw a post he put up. He got the championship. The Larry O'Brien trophy, and then he got a notepad on it. Hope he comes with fire, man.
Yeah.
But I don't think Drake, I don't know if he's competitive like that anymore. Because
he got some more people he got to diss. You know what I'm saying? He got to diss.
He got a long line. But see, you got to do like Jay-Z used to do, man. You know what I'm saying?
Just put them all, just give them all 1-2,
you're
1-2,
right.
Bar them out.
Everybody get a jab real quick, man.
Get your ass a jab. You a hoe, nigga. you a lame, you know what I'm saying? So he got a diss Future, Metro Boomin.
K-Dot, Rick Ross, now they say.
Rick Ross, Selena Gomez, apparently.
You bullshit. you bullshit.
I'm playing, man. But the way this shit going.
I believe you, though. That's crazy. I almost believed you, though.
It felt like it was real, right? Even when I had beef with Selena Gomez. He do got beef with Megan Thee Stallion, though. He was throwing us some bars, but that'd been funny if this Selena Gomez. Like, damn, bro.
I understand why you got beef with, man. You got his homeboy locked up. I don't know if Troy shot her not still, you know what I'm saying?
Kind of did it. that shit was a whole crazy situation, man. I didn't even want to really get into it, but that shit is wild, man. That's some wild shit in itself. But, yeah, man, you know, I feel people on that, man. But sometimes, yeah, like, you just got to play the background with that type of shit, man.
Meg done blew up now, huh? And, Glorilla.
Yeah, Glorilla got saying, man. She got like, she was like a -8 cup. She got a little C9, you know what I'm saying?
Damn.
She's stepping up, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Meg always look good, though, man. But you know what I'm saying?
Man,
this don't do no crimes around her.
Have you seen the before pictures of Glorilla?
Oh, my God, man. Walmart worker.
Man.
Walmart cashier.
Cuz. When you get that money, you just got to fix everything about yourself. You know
yeah,
what I'm saying?
Most definitely.
Whatever you don't like, just fix that shit, man.
Do it real quick. Do it real quick, man.
Damn.
Oh, my God, it's terrible. But, yeah, man.
No, I'm not going because my guy.
Man. I mean, that's the first thing to get done is them teeth, man.
I don't talk about my queens.
You don't talk about your queens like that? Yeah, the queens. But, yeah, man. Yeah, man, that's what they all do. They get that rapper package, you know, B-Will. Tit job and you know, teeth and shit. That's the first thing they do is get the teeth. Even Mello Bucks here in Chicago, she got her teeth done. She need to get some of the rest of that done. You know what I'm saying? But I ain't gonna
man,
get a shorty.
Man, don't do that. She throwing motherfuckers through glass windows.
I don't want no problems. I don't want no problems.
Leave that little killer alone.
Yeah, this motherfucker.
She don't give a fuck.
Man, this is a crazy little odd bitch. But anyway, but yeah, man, I'm just glad to hear the bars, man. I got excited. I like that duality he had. I might delete this later. J. Cole had, man. So I want to hear. That's what I hope comes from all this is this good music, man. Like it used to be, man. You remember the old days, Benny Siegel, Jada Kiss? That was the days, motherfucking locks coming at 50 Cent, man. That's the shit I miss, man. The battles, man. The real battles. Man. Not the whatever league they be doing the theatrical shit they do now. Like, I want to hear real rappers, not no Loaded Lux and all them fucking Mookie Blaylocks, Murder Mook and all them motherfucking losers. I don't want to hear nothing about you niggas that can't make tracks, bro. So
don't disrespect them guys. They got flow.
And Mad Hoffa.
They can't make a hit song, though. You know what I'm saying? They ain't got the techniques yet.
No, not yet. Not yet in the last 15 years.
Yeah.
But, yeah, Mav Hoffa, I love your show. Please stop having your song in the beginning of the fucking show.
Damn.
Nobody wants to see them videos. If you're going to be a journalist, be a journalist. You're going to be a podcaster, be a podcaster. I do not want to see them weak-ass songs in the beginning, okay? Side note.
Is this the year of beef, though? Because comedians beefing.
Yeah,
rappers,
man.
Rappers beefing.
I don't know, man. Interest is high. Maybe motherfucking taxes.
Beef sale?
Beef do sell. It definitely does. It always does.
Now you podcasters out there want some beef. Man, let
I'm
that starting shit be
shit.
Known,
let it be known, nigga.
That shit off
I smack T and tap his head. Nigga, what's up?
Right.
Yeah, man. I'm catching it. Catch Roy and Maul, man, at the mall, baby. Let's get it popping.
Straight up.
We got two, man, me and Mike. We going to win that. Man. We going to win. We going to win that. Gilly and Rallo. I'm going to hit Gilly in the neck. You know what I'm saying?
I don't know about Rallo. He might bite him on.
Yeah,
he bite when he fight.
Yo, he's from the cell, so you know what he doing. Wrestling and biting.
Hey, he probably still got a shank in his sock and shit.
Yeah, yeah.
Hell no.
Oh, man. Keep them pencils, keep them toothbrushes sharp.
Right.
Oh, man. But, yeah, man, I don't know, man. It's just a whole bunch of negativity going out there to me, man. I don't really like it, but I understand why people do it, man. It's press, man. You know what I'm saying? Cat Williams running a 4-2 and He's trying to be in the combine at 50 years old and shit. But yeah, man. I guess this. Hey, it's just that time for it, man. Beef sells, man. You know, negativity always flourishes for some reason, man. It's a sad thing.
Well, you gotta just be positive, now, man.
Yeah, man.
Dying left and right.
Yeah, man.
Fucking earthquakes in New York, boy. You know what I'm saying?
Oh shit. In the times now, I'm fucking with you.
Straight up, boy. I'm supposed to be going to New York soon, too. You know what I'm saying? Shit, got me nervous in the motherfucker.
Man, fuck that shit, man.
And one of my homegirls, she was in Taiwan.
Taiwan. Yeah.
They had some over there, you know what I'm saying? Some little earthquake over there and shit.
Yeah, and, man.
You know.
You remember these, a couple, what was that, like a year ago, they had that big ass,
You don't even know, no, you cut me off. Now, look, you ain't even know about the cicada bugs that's finna happen.
Oh, right. Yeah, that shit's coming, man. Oh, my God, that shit gonna be sick.
This shit out the Bible, baby.
Oh, my God. Then it got eclipsed to, like, in a couple days tomorrow.
Right, that's
oh,
what
my
saying.
God. This shit is the end of time shit, man.
That's what
I'm
scared saying.
Scared motherfucker. I'm gonna go baptize the tub right
man,
quick, man.
Motherfuckers. Niggas gonna
scary.
Start joining cults and shit. You know
that
what I'm saying?
Shit,
I'll be your prophet, goddamn it. You know what I'm saying?
Well, $9.99.
Have to pay that bread, though. You know what I'm saying? Follow greatness. God damn it.
Follow greatness, nigga. Yeah. But, yeah, man, shit getting crazy, man. Shit's getting crazy out here, man. You think that's why female basketball is getting good, man?
Jesus.
Like, shit is turning into man shit getting soft. Because, look, it was more
disrespect.
It was more fights than the female fights. I mean, in the female NCAA than the men's this year, man. It was crazy. Like, the females was getting at it.
Dudes just, like, running through plays, man. They weren't even trying too often.
Nah, man.
That was one of the disappointments about the NCAA men's thing now. They're not even trying to play hard, it seems like.
Yeah, they're like prima donnas.
Yeah. But the women's, man, they was fucking balling. I got to give it to them, man.
Man, they showing their ass. No pun intended. But yeah, I wish they was. But anyway, whatever goes now, I hope everybody's getting paid. Hope getting that money. But shit, man. I'd like to thank all of y'all today, man, for listening to us. We back. We're going to bring you more episodes. Oh, check us out on all social media sites. Greatness, you have anything you want to add?
Oh, y'all always follow Greatness at everything Greatness MJ, Snapchat, all that, Instagram. I'm here, your relationship guru. And your motivational speaker, always coming with any questions, DM. I'm saving relationships time, one person at a time. Or two people, right? It takes two people to make a relationship. Oh, man.
I'm saving one relationship at a time. And also, check us out on TikTok with Them Guys Podcast. Check us out on Instagram, Them Guys Podcast. Check us out on YouTube, Them Guys Podcast. You type it in, we everywhere. We on iHeart, we on Spotify, we on everywhere. And we love the comments, man. So keep on giving us those comments. Keep on giving us those love. And, you know, you help us with the show, man, with the topics and stuff, man. Y'all really some assholes sometimes. But, yeah, man, we appreciate it, though. We appreciate the love and the hate. So we'll see you next week, man. One.